lot of piping going around, which is confusing me at the end of the line. So what we've done is I've gotten some of these labels. I'm going to label like the diesel lines. So what we've got is that the diesel keeps coming back into the oil line to the heat exchanger. We've put in this return valve, so it's a non-return valve, so the diesel and the oil line won't be able to mix. Just to make sure that all the water is removed from the oil before it goes into the injectors, we had to order this little water trap. I had to order it from the UK as we couldn't find one in South Africa. So it works very simple. So the oil goes into this side, it catches all the water, and we can drain it off on this side, and it goes through. We installed the water separator directly from the first heat exchanger. After the second heat exchanger will be too high for this unit to handle. Water separates better with oil when it's hot. Today I've got some guys helping me out. Journey to
okay there.
Today we're going to be doing the exhaust. Man ET is going to be welding up this exhaust for us. So the exhaust used to run over this way, then up, over, and then down. They're going to take it down here for me, up and over, and out the other side.
Why am I short of attention? Got a short little span of attention, and all my nights are so long. Where's my wife and family? What if I die here? Who'll be my role model now that my role model is gone? You duck back down the alley with some roly-poly little bat-faced girl. All along, there were incidents and accidents. There were hints and allegations. If you'd be my bodyguard,
we're replacing this pipe. The pipe's not big enough to actually go over the hole, and we can't find another pipe that fits. So we're using this cool product called the rubber tape. It works very well in actually sealing the pipe up, and it fuses together. Yolandi's gonna help me after that today. The temperature gauge in the cab is showing that the exhaust is heating up the oil too much. I'll remove the nuts and make a little spacer so that it doesn't get as hot. So there's our little preheater. I got this heat shield. We'll hammer it down so that it fits into this shape here. So this is a type of thermal belting that will wrap around the exhaust pipe to try and get the heat down. Filling the tank up so it doesn't make an airlock, and that we can test the actual temperature inside the tank. Even if you're running the truck, I can even put my hand on this, it's not too hot. So I think that's perfect for the first stage, the preheating stage. And then after that, this plate heat exchanger should bring it up to 90 degrees Celsius, which is where we want it at, or at least 80 degrees Celsius. Hopefully I'll be able to run Betsy on cooking oil today for the first time. So if we did everything right, then it'll work. All of these lines are now empty, the oil side. So as you can see, there's nothing in there. I've got to attempt to bleed all of the oil through. I'll mix in some diesel to thin it out. All of this cooking oil was sponsored by my sister and my brother-in-law. They've got a food truck business. They use this oil to fry chips in. I've put it through one filter already about a year ago, but I'm going to put it through another filter. The pre-filtering stage is just, I used an old piece of bedding, so it's a net, just to get all the chip pieces out. that'll catch most of it, and the filtering system that we installed into the truck will do the rest of the work, hopefully. Everything's filled up with air at the moment, so it'll create an air lock. So I'm going to bleed the lines, I'll thaw the tanks with the oil as well, and then just hope for the best. You'll notice all the chip pieces, so all the food particles in the net. The rest of the filters in the system will take care of whatever's left in there. I realized that the main battery is done for in the truck, and I was having trouble to start it up, so I had to get another battery, so that's in the back at the moment, and I'm on my way to the farm. So we finally got the truck running. The first one is the one that's connected to the exhaust pipe, and the other one is the one that's connected to the engine water. So first heat exchanger, second heat exchanger, so that should hang around at 90, and then this one should hang around at about 60-70 degrees Celsius, then it's perfect. So that one's gonna pick up a little bit, and then we'll give it the first go and start swapping over to the oil. I'll start closing the diesel slightly, and also opening the oil little by little, and then hopefully we can get it to a stage that the diesel's completely closed, the oil's completely open, and the motor is running on oil. Betsy's on cooking oil for the first time now. Everything seems to be going smoothly. I'm gonna take it for a drive. Let's see what happens. The temperature looks like it's perfect. So very happy at the moment as everything worked out. She's driving on oil smoothly. I haven't had any hiccups. I've been driving around for at least 15 minutes. So it seems everything has worked out. So in order to turn off the motor, I've got to switch over to the diesel return and start opening the diesel tap slightly. This is the first time I'm doing this, by the way. I'm doing this so that the diesel flushes all the lines, so that when the oil cools down, doesn't get thick in the lines and actually block off anything. Okay, so the diesel is open. The oil is completely closed. We're only running off diesel now. I'll run it on the diesel for about 5 minutes or so, just to make sure that all the lines are clear from oil, and then I can switch it off.